So in July, I became 2 years natural, and my hair was growing out from a previous tapered cut. And then in July, I shaved all the sides of my hair off, and this was what I ended up with. And it was a really nice style. I really loved it. And what actually happened, y'all, is 4 months later, this is what happened. I ended up growing it out unintentionally. I just washed it and kept it up underneath wigs and didn't realize how fast my hair had grown in 4 months. So it grown so much, I didn't want to cut it because I liked the texture. So I decided to cut it again. And I think this is going to be a really good video to show you guys because a lot of you have probably tried this hairstyle and probably wondering how can you transition from one hairstyle to the next. And I said in a updated video on my natural hair that I was going to grow this style out possibly, and if that happens, I would cut it into a tapered cut. So as you can see here, I'm cutting it into a tapered cut. So as you can see here, I'm carefully trying to blend my new growth to the hair that I've had that was extremely long at the top. And I'm doing this in three sections. So that back section was a lot of work just trying to get it to match up to the length of my TWA that's going on in the sides and the back of my head. But once I got to the center section, what I did was cut it in a very long angle so that I would still have some length, a lot more length in the top of my head. And then once I got to this last section, pretty simple, just cut it in a long angle as well. So here I am with the final touches, and I'm going to be using my angled, well, tapered guard to my clippers. And my clippers are Andes. I got mine from a local beauty supply store, but you can find them at Walmart, Target, it does not matter. But they should come with guards, and I'm using another tapered guard, and I'm just pointing to show you the direction of how I use these. And that's how I'm able to taper my hair, is I use guards to do that. Clippers are totally different from trimmers, and I'll show you what those are in a second. But for the back of my hair, I start off with a number two guard, because they do not have a tapered guard that I know of for the back of your head. So I just use the longest one based on my hair length, because it's a fro right now, and I go downward. I know some barbers go upward, but for me it's easier for me to go downward, and then I'll start to use the number one guard and to kind of finish it off. So this is how I kind of get that tapered look in the back and still keep my hair looking somewhat even going into that tapered look. Now these are trimmers. They're usually smaller, and in some cases they do have guards to them for you to do small touch-ups and cuts, but I like to use my trimmers to kind of edge off my sideburns and the nape of my hair, or should I say the neck, back of my hair. So totally different. Can they be used the same? Yes, but I think trimmers are a lot better for edging up your hairline instead of using clippers to do it, even though you could do it with clippers. But it's just kind of like a little tip there that I'm giving you guys for those of you who want to try and do this on your own. So I am really excited about this haircut. I really love tapered styles. And this time my hair is a lot longer in the front than my last tapered cut. And I like that I can move it from one side to the other. So to me, it's kind of versatile. So I just wanted to share with you guys how I cut my hair again. So I'm going to let it grow out. Don't worry. Just to see what the shape will change or transform into. But other than that, that's pretty much it. You'll probably see more videos of me styling this hairstyle. I did post pictures on my Instagram page of the styling look, so make sure you follow me on Beauty Cut Right. And I also have previous videos of how I cut my hair and how I've styled my previous haircut. So make sure you check that out, and I'll see you guys in the next video.